Well, of course, we couldn't really expect anything more from the Destroyer showing what he thinks of Gene Storm, showing why he disrespected Gene Storm last week. I mean, for crying out loud, Destroyer going inside his hometown. He's not going to pull no punches on that fateful night, April 24th at Pandemonium in the main event for the UWA Championship. Well, that's what we're going to James Corp back to. This time will be with Michael Strahan. Koko, one of the number one contenders for this championship. He'll be the triple threat match. Take up Ursa Auto to this champion as well as Mortal Loca.
The following contest is a three-way duel. Coming down the aisle, now residing in Silver Spring, Maryland, she is everyone's favorite Indian, Koko.
Consider this one, folks. Kind of a pandemonium preview match. Koko's going to be in a triple threat match with the likes of Kortas and the Double X champion, Wildfire. But speaking of Wildfire, she even Aaron M. challenged Wildfire for a Double X champion with Wildfire to take it seriously. She's kind of a threat, got back from pregnancy, rusty as hell, overweight, out of shape, to compete in the ring anytime soon. Wildfire didn't take her seriously at all. You know, last week we saw Koko, we saw Mona Loca, and we saw her come to blows. We got a huge preview with the spent at Pandemonium, and Koko's, told everyone, unless it was episode of a solo, Mona Loca was back on the injured list, after what she did right through that clean PT, through the stiff her back and let first fight, but I think we found out that was all overhype, exaggeration. Mona Loca still healthy.
Cutting down the aisle, from Vienna, Austria, she is the albatross, Karen Kortas.
The Kortas, she kind of had her plate full. She got a huge win over her friend, Crimshana Blade, last week. Of course, Crimshana Blade asked for that match. It was that misunderstanding that they both had. That was another first fight with Karen Kortas attacked Crimshana Blade, but I guess the reason behind it was that was just Karen Kortas thinking on the fly. She just couldn't to find some way to get Karen Blade away from the likes of Antan and Randy Diva, because Karen Kortas in her mind believes that those two can single-handedly spark, they can be the catalyst to what causes Karen Blade to transform into that Pandemonium dragon once again. And obviously Karen Kortas thinks they need to defeat Karen Blade to prevent her, what any way is necessary to prevent her from transforming once again. But when he transformed, she is absolutely unstoppable. No one can face her whatsoever.
On her way to the middle, she is the current Double S champion from Melbourne, Australia. She is Wildfire.
This is Wildfire, the running rough shot, the wrecking shot, ever since he transformed from Andorra and became Wildfire back at Halloween Night Bash last year. She only has one loss on her record so far, losing to Renegade Diva, but of course she made amends for that when she defeated Renegade Diva a week later when the double champ was on the line. I remember, folks, Aaron Emeny, last year, right after Beach Party Slam, she won the double championship back at Beach Party Slam, but then relinquished it on the next episode of Assault, and then also found out she was pregnant. Ever since then, he uncovered this secret rivalry that's been brewed between Andorra, which is now, of course, Wildfire and Aaron Emeny. And the independence of these two, Wildfire and Emeny, went back and forth, never really thought of who truly was the better individual. But unfortunately for Aaron Emeny, she got pregnant, was able to settle for it with Wildfire, but now she might have a possible chance in the near future. When Aaron Emeny gets back into shape and loses that fat she gained during the pregnancy. And I guess so far, Aaron Emeny is kind of keeping her childbirth kind of hush-hush. She still hasn't even mentioned the name of her baby boy yet.
Looking back to the action here, folks, and going back to Wildfire here for a second rock shot. And of course, he's not going to take Aaron Emeny seriously. I mean, come on, in the words of a great man, she's fat, okay? She is old. She can't go on anymore. She's not in this business. She shouldn't even have a contract. The fact that she still has a contract, the Enforcer still allowing her to compete is utterly ridiculous. So, of course, no one's going to take her seriously, and Wildfire shouldn't have to face her at Pandemonium of all places, because she's just not worth it.
Things for that not necessarily rant, you just missed that spot with Koko and Karen Kortas, and FYI, Aaron Emeny's only 28 years old. Don't give me that she's too old shit. For crying out loud, she's the same exact age as Wildfire, for crying out loud. We're back to the actors, like, more impartial commentary here. But you see, Koko is some of a, like I said before, this is kind of a Pandemonium preview match, and it's a huge advantage for Koko to be in this triple threat match, unlike her opponents Ursula, Arellano, and Mona Loca at Pandemonium, because you see, win, lose, or draw, Koko can learn some, learn something from her her mistakes, or can learn from any type of possible advantages she can gain in this matchup and apply it when the women's title is on the line at Pandemonium here.
Who the hell cares about Koko? This is a test match for anyone. This is a test match for Wildfire and what she can deliver here in the UWA, which is a lot, by the way. And look at this. Just going right after Karen Kortas, sneaking out the ring, doing the veteran instincts would tell her to do. And picking her spots and taking advantage. And now she can handle herself quite fine here.
And she seemed quite fine. She got blindsided by Coco's drop kick there. But so far, you see Karen Kortas is pretty much, got the short end of the stick in this triple threat match. It seems like Wildfire and Coco just had the upper hand with her since the very beginning. Karen Kortas obviously has a lot on her mind right now. She has to deal with, Anna Tan, Renegade Demon, of course, Crimshana Blade, two points of living in fear, hoping that Crimshana Blade doesn't transform in the near future and wreak havoc. I mean, we heard what Renegade Diva and Karen Kortas said, but I'm not going to say what they said because I don't want to risk Crimshana Blade over, hearing my commentary that could put, her future in absolute jeopardy here in the UWA, so I'm not going to go over that crap. And, oh my! A huge right arm close. I take on. Oh, look at this. Koko opportunistically getting the pin. Just like that. That could easily be how Koko or anyone can win a triple threat match at Pandemonium and become the women's champion. Or Ursa Arion can retain the women's championship. Just like that. And oh, but the throws came. And Kendrick's on her back. A huge Samoan drop.
It was a momentary slip up, Rock Top. But you saw right there. She came back. I mean, yeah, okay. That maybe that wasn't smart to taunt after she did that move. But look how she's coming back right here, and now she's going to put it all away and end her forever with the Firestorm. It's all but over here, folks. Wildfire, look at this move. We haven't seen it. Oh, my goodness. Wait, what is Koko doing here? Oh, come on, right? She can't do that.
Technically, it's legal throwing out Wildfire and obviously being very opportunistic, like I said moments ago, getting the pin on the prone Karen Kortas, and just like that, Coco's victorious. And that's exactly what Ursa Arion and Mona Loca has to take into consideration. They can lose their match that easily. That's the dangers of being a triple threat match. Matches can end out of nowhere. You have to have eyes on the back of your freaking head, and I guess Wildfire didn't have eyes on the back of her freaking head tonight. Totally think Koko coming blindside
her. I can't believe it. But look, I can't believe I just saw here. I mean, Wildfire had this match won right here, but that damn Koko had a stick her nose where it didn't belong. She couldn't pick up the victory herself. She had to pick it up after Wildfire hit the Firestorm.
Oh my god, that's a bullshit. Well, I know you didn't like it, Olsen, but I bet you Aaron Aries is laughing like hell right about now.
Here's your winner, Koko.
If I know who is not laughing, Ursa Arion and Mona Loca. I mean, they just saw one of their possible ways to saw one of their opponents for Pandemonium go over huge tonight and quite possibly win at Pandemonium, become the second time ever become a women's champion in a huge triple threat normal match at Pandemonium 11. So I guess Koko changed her mind. I guess we're still going to have a normal match, like she said from the very beginning. But this time, instead, it's going to be with no disqualification rules. So I guess that might be in favor, make the match more, a little more even, playful, and obviously, give the fans, more a cheer about. But then again, Koko is the type of person who doesn't want to give a shit about the fans. But either way, I guess Koko has the right motive to go behind this, but that would be a great match. This is going to be a Pandemonium.